Good morning, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. Scary moments for a Rochester woman who scared off a would-be burglar yesterday after the suspect kicked in her door. It led to two arrests for multiple break-ins. Within minutes, police caught Ryan Feeney. He was charged with burglary and receiving stolen property. Jacqueline Meyer was also arrested and charged with receiving stolen property. Police say at least three homes had been burglarized. A family in Chester is crediting their dog with saving them from a house fire. The flames broke out early yesterday morning at a house on Fremont Road Extension. The fire chief believes it was caused by an electrical malfunction and was likely smoldering for hours in the basement while the homeowner slept. Fortunately, that guy right there, the family dog, caught wind of the smoke and alerted the homeowners, who made it out safely.
We got up and got the cats into carriers and threw a leash on the dog and grabbed what we could and got out the door. And by the time we got around the house to the front, we heard a big snapping noise. And then when we looked up, there were flames in the window. So I would say we probably got out just in the nick of time.
Certainly did. One firefighter suffered minor burns while battling this fire, but he is expected to be okay. Jury deliberations continue today in the trial of a woman from Rwanda accused of lying about her role in the 1994 genocide to gain U.S. citizenship. Closing arguments in the trial of Beatrice Munyenyezi were made on Friday. If found guilty, Munyenyezi faces deportation to Rwanda and a possible life sentence there. At the State House this week, lawmakers are expected to vote on three abortion-related bills. One of the measures would require women to wait 24 hours and be given information on fetal development before getting an abortion. Also this week, right to work is back to the head of several collective bargaining bills. The legislation would allow non-union employees to abstain from paying union fees for contract negotiations. Governor Lynch vetoed last year's right to work bill. Well, today marks the 100th anniversary of the Girl Scouts, and Scouts here are celebrating. More than 100 Girl Scouts gathered to make form a number 100 in Hooksett. Girls from Hooksett, Bow, Pembroke, and Allenstown all helped form this very large number. Afterwards, they celebrated with what else? Birthday cake. That's it for this webcast. We hope you can join us for News 9 at noon, and you can check out our next webcast around 1 this afternoon. Have a great Monday, everybody.